Along the miles of sand which adjoins Rajasthan's Thar Desert, you will find Barmer, India's fifth largest district. But on a closer look, you can also see a silent revolution taking shape. Women in this remote area are taking giant strides towards financial independence and self-empowerment. Yes Arts and Culture, a division of Yes Global Institute, the think tank of Yes Bank, is working with women artisans in Barmer to upgrade their craft and design skills.
Yes Arts and Culture is one of the key pillars behind the Yes Global Institute. You know, when we started under Mr. Rana Kapoor's vision as a bank, the first professional entrepreneurship driven bank, the idea was not just to make sure that our money works for us and creates more money. The idea was to create the first Indian homegrown brand which will also contribute to the community. The premise behind the Yes Global Institute is to use the twin levers of knowledge and technology. The Yes Global Arts and Culture is one of the most critical pillars of the Yes Global Institute.
Yes Arts and Culture takes a dual approach of dialogues and projects for the promotion of India's rich cultural heritage. The dialogues that we undertake are meant for a broader understanding of India's cultural and creative industries.
Applique and embroidery work are unique craft forms that Rajasthani women have been practicing for ages. Beautiful patterns, cut, stitched, embroidered, are turned into stunning pieces of art. But in this remote part of the country, artisans and their craftsmanship were facing challenging times. The art form in its current shape was not responding to urban trends. And the women artisans were facing pressure to share profits with middlemen.
पहले तो मने थोड़ा पैसा मिलता तो 2 रुपया मिलता तो मैं मोर घना दनिया कदी खोलता और कदी हकर नहीं तो भले खोलते।
इनको पता नहीं होता कि आगे कितना पैसा मिलता है और हमें कितना दिया जाता है। बिचौलिए जो लोग एजेंट हुआ करते थे वो उनको उनसे काम करवाते थे, इनको थोड़ा सा धान दे देते थे या 2-3 रुपये दे देते थे, ऐसा करके वो काम करवाते थे। फिर हमने सोचा कि शोषण हो रहा है।
Yes Arts and Culture has partnered with Concern India Foundation to address this challenge at the grassroots. They are managing learning centers in 2 villages of the Barmer district, Sanawada and Bachrao. Artisan women gather here to further develop their skills. The training is not only helping them improve quality, but is also opening new retail avenues through innovation in stitching and design. Jaipur.com, India's premier e-marketplace, has also been brought on board to facilitate a collaborative design project which will enable traditional applique to come out of its limited role as an ethnic craft form. A new wearable line created with assistance of a professional designer will be featured on Jaipur.com through the NGO partner GVCS.
Yes, they're able to produce the product now, but where is the demand coming from? Where is the market coming from? So that is where the project has helped them to link it to the markets. And Yes Bank's association is going to go a long way out here because they're helping us to further create this linkage, especially with our design intervention.
Earlier this year, we were successful in launching Agenda 25 by 25. We put out a war cry under the visionary leadership of Mr. Kapoor when we say by 2025, can we have at least 25% of all entrepreneurs in India as women? This is one such powerful initiative that rises from the grassroots and empowers lives.
Lives of more than 1,000 women are being touched by this initiative. The craft is evolving, and the women are now more financially confident and aware of government schemes. As they merge new trends and contemporary cuts with their traditional craft, the products infiltrate a bigger market. The women involved in this project have seen an increase of up to 50% of their income. These women are now becoming financially independent in a male-dominated social ecosystem. With an increased income, their children are able to remain in school and their families are achieving greater stability. Cut to it!